2017 Royal Edinburgh Military Tattoos Fanfare to the Oceans greets their Royal Highnesses Prince Charles, Duke of Rothesay, and Prince William, Earl of Strathearn. First, the imported business of a dram and the lone piper's toast.
Hail, may the foul trick Cthulhu, you Bannigan Asian, Agus to the castle, more in likens than the guy with she. Slanted on Vanry, Archinard, Archelfinia, Slant the Avila.
The toast, welcome to the city of Edinburgh and to the castle, and health to you all. The mast, pipes and drums. The 2017 tattoo sets out to splash the tartan, and the splash becomes a mighty wave as the pipes and drums march across the drawbridge to When the Pipers Play. Now framed by the statues of Robert the Bruce and William Wallace, those legendary heroes of Scottish independence, the march is, of course, Scots wha hae. In his first tattoo as director of Army Bagpipe Music and Highland Drumming, Major Gordon Rowan has compiled a set of tunes that will recall the 1745 Jacobite uprising. We'll be right back. the band of the Royal Regiment of Scotland joins for the real Mrs. Macleod of Rousey. With his new mace in hand, Senior Drum Major Michael Hay of the Royal Regiment of Scotland gives the command.
Three fawn bands! Where the centre? Quick! March!
And the mast, pipes and drums reform to the march, Blue Bonnets Over the Border. Mass, pipes and drums march off, the song of farewell, Will You No Come Back Again? The mast, pipes and drums. The call of the Tutari marks the arrival of the Indian Navy Band. 2017 commemorates 70 years of Indian independence, and the band, led by the drum major and conductor Bandmaster Vincent Johnson, crossed the drawbridge with a tune that extends the traditional Hindu greeting, Namaste. Adding cultural sparkle to this commemoration of Indian independence, the Indian Navy Band are now joined by a team of dancers from the New Delhi-based Teamwork Arts. tattoo dance company add to the spectacle. Bollywood comes to Hollywood. The Indian Navy Band, Teamwork Arts, and the Tattoo Dance Company. Remembering the old alliance, the ancient bond of friendship between Scotland and France, this is the fanfare band of the 9th French Marine Infantry Brigade, with the musical alliance of bagpipes and bombards. Le played by adjudant-chef Fabrice Zeni. The tune is Les Vents du Large, The Sea Breeze. The bandsmen in white are the Chasseurs Alpins, the Alpine Hunters. Mesdames et messieurs, take your partners for the Cercle Circassien. Transition into the Daft Punk medley is eased by the addition of signature helmets and a virtual mirror pole. We'll be right back. fanfare band of the 9th French Marine Infantry Brigade. Merci beaucoup, mesdames et messieurs. The Shetland fiddlers, Hjalte Ben Hoga, bring the spirit of Up Hell Yeah to Edinburgh. Shetland's midwinter fire festival of Up Hell Yeah has the ritual burning of a Viking longship as its climax. This longship, the Mirri Dancer, takes its name from Aurora Borealis, the Northern Lights. Hjalte Ben Hoga light up the Edinburgh night. Tattoo dance director Aileen Robertson has picked the best of Highland dancers from around the world to launch the Tattoo Dance Company. The music is composed by Finlay MacDonald. Time to splash the tartan. We'll be right back. Tattoo Dance Company. Established in 1951, the Japanese-grown self-defense force Central Band has remained Japan's best-known wind ensemble, performing at state and national events. On their first appearance at the Tattoo, the band delivered a varied program of contemporary and traditional performance, with a few surprises. The Edinburgh Night echoes to a virtuoso drumming display courtesy of Sergeant Cadome. Leading Private Michiko Matsunaga. Stunning. Under the command of Colonel Higuchi, the Japanese-grown Self-Defense Force Central Band leaves the arena. Harking back to the days of whales and sailing ships, the United States Naval Forces Europe Band is very comfortable at a maritime-themed tattoo. With a nimble hornpipe, the tattoo dance company raised the sails. Alex Wong steps out to show the rest of the company that this is also very much a boys' game. Led by Director of Music, Lieutenant Commander Charles White, they fill the esplanade with a selection of sea shanties and hornpipes, played with the usual waves of American pizzazz. Break drum? No, drum break. Dating from 1897, Asleep in the Deep reminds us that not all who go down to the sea in ships will return to dry land safe and sound. Listen closely to the words of musician third class Patrick Milton from Charleston, South Carolina.
Stormy the night and the waves roll high, bravely the ship doth ride. Hark while the lighthouse bell's solemn cry rings o'er the sullen tide. There on the deck see two lovers stand, heart to heart beating in hand, though death be near, she knows no fear, while at her side is the one ever dear. Loudly the bell in the old tower rings, bidding us list to the warning it brings. Sailor, take care. Beware, beware, beware. Many brave hearts are asleep in the deep, so beware, beware. Many brave hearts are asleep in the deep, so beware, beware.
The Roscommon hornpipe heralds the return of the Tattoo Dance Company. Anchors away, the United States Naval Forces Europe Band takes its leave. Castle Esplanade transforms into a quiet Highland glen. The band of the Royal Regiment of Scotland is followed by a small group of redcoats. It is a well-known fact that Jacobite rebels are also partial to a Highland glen, so there is more than a strong likelihood that there may be a noisy skirmish in store. Thank you. with the retreat of the Redcoats, the Jacobites celebrate a victory. The campaign was to end in tragedy at the Battle of Culloden in April 1746. Bonnie Prince Charlie fled to Skye before returning to exile in Rome. The story continues with two of Scotland's best-loved songs, The Skye Boat Song and Caledonia, Dougie MacLean's anthem to exiled Scots everywhere. The pipes and drums and the dancers form the pattern of the white cockade, the traditional symbol of support for the Jacobite cause. Castle Esplanade is transformed into the flight deck of a modern aircraft carrier. The Lynx Mark III maritime helicopter, with Royal Marines on board, moves into position, and the scene is set. Center stage is the Queen's Colour Squadron as they prepare to display their complex silent drill. They are joined by the band of the Royal Air Force Regiment, marking its 75th anniversary. Queen's Colour Squadron and the band of the Royal Air Force Regiment, saluted by the Duke of Rothesay. Recognised as the most versatile, adaptable and effective military musical organisation of its kind in the world, the Royal Marines Band Service continues to be in a class of its own. Tonight, The massed bands of Her Majesty's Royal Marines are from Portsmouth, Scotland, and the Commando Training Centre. The inimitable signature tune, A Life on the Ocean Wave. Ship's bell commemorates 100 years of the Women's Royal Naval Services, better known as the Wrens. Thank you. Royal Marine Drum Corps. Perfect percussion. Senior Drum Major Buster Brown gives the command. Then the bands reform with a new march, written for the launch of the aircraft carrier HMS Queen Elizabeth. The 2017 Tattoo's Principal Director of Music, Lieutenant Colonel Nick Grace, OBE, takes up the baton for Two Steps from Hell's epic track, Flight of the Silverbird. The soloist is musician Reuben Hanna.
Thank you.
The huge cast is assembled, and all eyes turn to the sky for the nightly tattoo fireworks display. The accompanying music is Michael McDermott's arrangement of the Procol Harum track, Conquistador. Sergeant Andy Platt, Royal Marines. Overseen by Major Stephen Small, this truly international ensemble gathers for the tunes Evolution, Donald Do, and Black and White. We'll be right back. The tattoo has two Guards of Honour this year. First, the Royal Air Force Regiment with their regimental march, Holyrood. Royal Navy Guard of Honour is from Her Majesty's Naval Base Clyde at Faslane. The official march, Heart of Oak. The national anthem. Now that international anthem of friendship that Robert Burns gave to the world, Auld Lang Syne. The assembled cast now takes time to reflect as they join together in the late Leonard Cohen's evocative Hallelujah. Thank you. Michiko Matsunaga. Sunset. The lowering of the flags. Lights out. High on the castle ramparts, the lone piper, Corporal Charles Johnson MacLean, plays the slow air, Lochaber No More. It's time to bid farewell to this international cast. The Queen's Colour Squadron. The Royal Navy. The Tattoo Dance Company. The Bollywood Dancers. The Vikings, Redcoats and Jacobites. Kjeldrup and Holger, the Shetland Fiddlers. With no war to bide a war. This is the 19th successive sold-out season of the Royal Edinburgh Military Tattoo, supported by the Royal Bank of Scotland. And it's the 23rd and final show for tattoo production manager Steve Walsh. He will hang up his hat, and his sure hand will be missed. Producer Brigadier David Alfrey has delivered a rich variety, bringing people together and celebrating what makes them gloriously different. massed pipes and drums led by Drum Major Michael Hay from the Royal Regiment of Scotland march towards the cobbles of Castle Hill to the fine tune that has taken generations of pipes and drums back to barracks. The Black Bear. It's been a right royal evening of entertainment at Edinburgh Castle, and this is Bill Paterson wishing you, wherever in the world you've been watching, good fortune and good health until we meet again.